Hey y'all, so I am wanting y'all to see my journey to how I made my concert happen. And you know, I have some clips of rehearsals and stuff like that, you know, just so y'all can get a feel of my preparation for the big show. And of course, I'm not always glamorous, so you know, there's some shots of me not glamorous, but I'm just, you know, that's just me being the real me. And you know, I'm human, so you know, it is what it is. But yeah, so I just wanted y'all to see this. It's kind of like a little mini documentary thing or whatever, behind the scenes of me making my concert happen. So I hope y'all like it, and here we go. Okay y'all, so I am planning for my own concert. I decided I wanted to have my own concert for my birthday. And so, you know, I'm planning this months in advance. So, you know, I'm planning this all by myself for right now. And, you know, trying to make sure everything I want done to be done. Now, the reason for me doing this is because I feel like I can pull off a concert, and that I want people to see what I see in myself, because I know I have a lot to offer, and I want y'all to see it. So I'm gonna have y'all on this journey of me preparing for this concert. Gonna, you know, be there for like the photo shoots and, you know, the preparation for, as far as like, you know, with my pen and paper and, you know, just trying to get everything straightened out. It's a lot. I'm not rich, so you know, this gotta come out of my pocket, so that means I need to work to make that money. But yes, so it seems like I'm just working just about every day to make money to maintain my regular bills on top of money to make this show happen. Now you're not just gotta worry about other things. Merchandise. Dancers, makeup artists, hairstylists,
like, bye,
and some other things. But yeah, so I am going to do a total of 6 songs, 3 cover songs, and 3 originals. And yeah, so basically, you know, I work throughout the day, and at night I am planning, researching a lot of things. But yeah, so I want to take y'all on this journey with me and see me prepare for this. This also includes vocal training up until then, working, like rehearsing with dancers once I get closer to the show. And, you know, make sure I work on me staying in shape. I'm going to be doing a little dieting. No, not losing weight. Maintaining my weight. And making sure, you know, I'm in shape to dance and do all of that. So, yeah. Y'all stay tuned on this journey with me. And here we go.
Y'all, when I started off, like, planning this, it was just me, myself, and I. Like, I didn't have no team, nothing, no sponsors, no investors, nothing. So when I say like I had to work every single day, I didn't have a 9-to-5. I ain't had no 9-to-5 in like 2 years. Like, I've been doing nothing but Uber Eats, DoorDash, Shipt, like just independent contract work for 2 years, doing it full time. And that's been like my income. Like, I have my own apartment. Like, I've been able to maintain my bills doing this. And so I wasn't working every single day before all of this idea came about. Like, I literally started working just about every day, and that was putting wear and tear on my car and my body.
What's up, y'all? So I am here in Dallas at my friend's studio, dance studio, and I am going to be rehearsing for my concert. And you know, I need to work on, you know, my vocals. Of course, that's what I need to work on. So I'm gonna let y'all, you know, check in on me rehearsing one of my songs for the concert. So yeah, y'all stay tuned. Yeah. I am here for you. What you want to do, whatever it is, I will take control. Okay, y'all. So that was me, you know, just, you know, rehearsing how I'm singing the song, working on my breathing and stuff like that. So now I'm about to put a little choreography with that so that I can work on my breathing at the same time as moving. So here we go. Okay, y'all, so don't judge me for having the cord wrapped up. I just did not want to trip over the cord while I was up there practicing, you know, rehearsing with, you know, some light moves for right now. So don't judge me. What y'all just heard was not my best vocally. That was, you know, me trying to figure out how I want to sing Take Control and also working on my breathing while singing as well, and, you know, working on my stamina, because like I have my own treadmill, and what I would do a lot of times during this preparation of my concert is I would run on the treadmill, and then right, I would do that a certain amount of time, and then I would stop, and then I would go right into singing one of my songs, and then get back on the treadmill again. And you know, every time I would stop from on the treadmill and sing the songs, I would work on my breathing right then and there. And that's not something that you can fix overnight. Like, that is to be fixed in due time. Like, this, it takes time. So that's what, you know, I was doing. Now, don't get me wrong, I definitely can sing Take Control way better than that. I will give you what you want. But that was just, you know, practice. Like, y'all not gonna always hear me being perfect, like sounding good every single time. Like, I'm not afraid for y'all to hear my mistakes, or I'm not saying it was a mistake, but to, you know, not hear me at my best. Like, I want y'all to like see my growth, if you know what I mean. But yeah, like, I could definitely sing that real good. Like, it just takes practice, y'all. It just takes practice. But yeah, it's, I got it in the bag now. Like, I do. I figured it out for the show. Okay, y'all. So, I, you know, woke up, get my makeup together. And, you know, while I'm getting my makeup together, I would, you know, start my vocal warm-ups, which is yawning. Yawning is a part of it, which There's something I could do for like 5 minutes. And while I am doing that, I'm doing my makeup. So, yeah. I mean, like I said, this is my preparation for the big day, my concert. And, you know, also while I'm doing it, I might do, get some more advice from other vocal coaches on YouTube, you know, that I could probably add to, you know, what I already do. You know, it's always room for improvement in other ways to, you know, get my voice together, get my voice ready, prepared for a show. Because, you know, some ways of doing certain things might not be for everybody. So, you know, it's all about finding that time to, you know, get that, find the right thing for you. So, yeah, this is my journey, y'all. Yes, I'm allowing y'all to see me with my wig cap on, without my wig. I'm not always 100% glamorous all the time, you know. But I'm just letting y'all see the real and, you know, just taking y'all on my journey. So here we go. So at this point, you know, my money was so tight. Like, I'm up here working almost every day and trying to pay my bills and trying to have some extra money to go towards, you know, other bigger things to make this concert happen. So I really didn't have the money to just, at that time, to just pay for a physical vocal coach to be like in front of me and like actually working on my vocals. So I went to somebody I know, call it YouTube University, but it's basically YouTube. And so, you know, it was a professional celebrity vocalist, you know, vocal coach on there. And they, you know, I went and learned some things on there and did some exercises on there from that. So, yeah, I mean, I had to do what I had to do, but I couldn't afford it, y'all. I could not afford a vocal coach to be in front of me. So, yeah. As far as working out, trying to stay in shape, what I would do is, you know, sometimes before I would, you know, have rehearsal with my dancers, I would go up there extra early and just, you know, get on the treadmill and, you know, get on the treadmill for a while before, you know, they arrive. So I would just do that, you know, for a little bit before they arrive, and then we'll start our, you know, dance rehearsals. So yeah, but I'm about to let y'all see some of the rehearsals that we have. It's been some rehearsals where we all wasn't able to be there all at the same time. So, you know, if that was to happen, we would film us doing the choreography and then send it to the dancer. So, yeah, that's what we did, but we made it work. So, check it out. Yeah.
overall, like, I really liked how it turned out for me. Because, like, y'all, I was about to say, man, I quit. Forget this. Because, like, you know, I was dealing with haters and dealing with finance problems, you know, just like doing things by myself starting off. But then, you know, I ended up getting help, you know, ended up getting a few sponsors. And Stephen Bailey helped me. He was basically my right-hand guy to help me put all this together because he has experience making concerts happen, knows how it's supposed to go. Just me learning from him along the way. And, you know, it's a lot, y'all. It's a lot to be trying to do this by yourself independently because usually record labels are over this and the artist is just focused on being an artist. Like, that's really how it's supposed to be. But it's been times where I cried because it was just so much that I was doing by myself. Like, I am an independent recording artist, y'all. It is not easy for independent artists to do something like this, this big, by themselves. Like, there's a team that is needed to make this happen. And then, you know, dealing with haters, making statuses about me and, you know, online and stuff, you know, throwing shots or whatever. But that actually made me laugh because, you know, I have my knowledge in whatever I do. But what kind of was making me want to quit was, you know, doing all that by myself, is dealing with the finances and stuff. So, but I'm glad it turned out good. Like, it's just a lot. Like, I'm just so blessed and grateful, and y'all see what happened.
Keep it.